This video is sponsored by Skillshare. One thing that's most certainly true for all creatives or anyone preoccupied by the weight of wanting to express their ideas is that it's very hard to stop thinking and especially to stop fantasizing. No matter whether I'm out for a run or driving back from getting groceries or even in the middle of the day job, I often find myself dreaming, fantasizing, thinking about the things that would be fun to bring to light. Here's just a stupid example of this. I've had this idea of wanting to make a video with like a long tracking shot, something in the vein of 1917. And yet I know that I'm not capable of doing this right now. I just don't have that skill with a camera. And yet whenever I go into the fantasy, I see this nighttime cinematic 4K, really dynamic movement and a tracking shot that is just really fun to watch. And I didn't know what I'd use it for, but I just had this instinct of wanting to make it. The temptation with something like this is to stay stuck in the fantasy, because if I were to attempt it, the shots wouldn't look anywhere as good as they did in my mind's eye. It's combating this instinct that carries the weight of all of creativity in it. We can choose to ponder, plan, evaluate, maybe even decide that something will be pursued years in the future. But the truth is, nothing will happen, not until you decide to sacrifice that perfect fantasy and to act. To paraphrase the great Jordan Peterson, one of the reasons that childhood is so nostalgic and warm for a lot of people is because of the possibility that it represented, the potentiality. As kids, we have so much potential. We have time on our side, and yet importantly, we haven't achieved anything. In contrast, as adults, we're no longer seen as those fun-eyed kids. We become like Captain Hook, the pirate who's being chased by the dragon of time. The battle then for any creative or any entrepreneur is that of their fantasies against their realities. And I would argue that it's best to choose reality every time. Let the fantasy serve as an engine, as a beacon of light that you might look out to occasionally to sort of feel you, to tell you what your North Star is, to tell you what your ideal looks like. But don't let fantasy get in the way of you working with imperfection, the muddiness, the raininess, the inefficiencies, because those things will invariably come up in reality. What we work with, what we do, will never look as good as it did in our mind. The great Christopher Nolan once gave a speech at Princeton University. If you haven't realized by now, I'm a huge Christopher Nolan fanboy. But in that speech, he said that we should chase our reality. In the great tradition of these speeches, generally someone says something along the lines of, chase your dreams. But I don't want to tell you that because I don't believe that.
I don't want you to chase your dreams. I want you to chase your reality. And I want you to understand that you chase your reality not at the expense of your dreams, but as the foundation of your dreams.
For someone like Nolan, who has addressed the themes of reality, time, dreams, memory, I think this is very significant that he said we should choose our reality before our dreams. The reality serves as the foundation. It provides you struggle, disappointment, pain, loss of money, loss of time, but it also gives you innovation, improvement, cunning, the ability to achieve things. And so this video is just a simple, unoriginal reminder that if you have any idea, whether it is to learn code, if you want to start a business, if you want to start a YouTube channel, if you want to take up martial arts, or even if you want to take on a 90-second tracking shot that you'd be completely trash at, go for it. Because even if reality is far more messy, far more ugly than the fantasy, it will serve as the foundation. Before closing out this video, I also want to give a quick acknowledgement to today's video sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community that offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on topics such as illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Classes tend to be short, many are under an hour, but they're incredibly information rich. I'm actually continually astounded by the fact that Skillshare, more than any other online platform, has helped me get competent at skills that I actually want to be good at and skills that I can turn something into. I've definitely spent several hundreds of hours learning about topics that I have no interest in that I never ended up using, and yet I'm blown away by the fact that with a mere 2 or 3 hours of sincere effort on a Skillshare class, I can do something new. I can learn something and put it into practice on something that I want to make for myself. My favorite class on Skillshare up until now has been Ali Abdaal's course on Final Cut Pro X. If you have a YouTube channel or you're thinking about starting one and you're not completely confident with your editing, this might be an amazing resource to start with. I especially appreciated his takes about how to cut together an A-roll faster using shortcuts, and also how to make your audio sound better. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description box will get a 2-month free trial to Skillshare Premium so that they can explore their creativity. And thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Before the production of any major movie, there's usually a process called location scouting. Dedicated personnel decide if a particular location, venue, terrain is suitable for getting a point across, to communicating a narrative, to sharing that story. In that process of confirming, evaluating, deciding, there is perhaps a sense of comfort. You haven't made the wrong decision yet. You still have the option to live into the fantasy of what you're about to do, of what could happen, and how great it's going to be. But the truth is, nothing will happen until you decide. Until you decide to close every other door, to pick one option, and then to act. To bring that fantasy into reality. But with that being said, for those of us who are willing to forsake those fantasies so that we can do something in reality, to build a foundation, even if it's uglier, messier, muddier, to us I say,